sharing passwords.
Mm-hmm.
So that's very common, ano? When you share a password, kasi yung ginagawa namin sa office, kumbaga nasa policy namin ganito. If an email is sent using your account, we will assume that it came from you.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
Yes. Ngayon, kung sasabihin mo hindi ako yan, kailangan ikaw mag-prove na hindi ikaw yon, which is, you know, medyo mahirap, but mali mo nga naman. Pero i-assume namin na galing sa'yo. Meaning, responsable ka dyan, huwag mong isi-share sa iba.
We're live again for another episode of HR Shouts and Whispers. Siyempre, una sa lahat, happy new year. Diba? Siyempre, episode 108 na tayo. Siyempre, my name is Ken Somera. Alright, one of your hosts for tonight. And ang main host natin, of course, Cristina Reclamado. Hi, Chris! Long time!
Yes, hi, Ken! Okay, and then hi to good. The FB good community. Okay, so it's been a long time since we had our next episode. Okay, but anyway, okay, what we are to discuss today is actually has something to do with, okay, so syempre lahat tayo naka-work from home. And then usually, okay, we're using IT. Okay, and then, you know, we are streaming a lot of data, exchanging a lot of data. So it's about cybersecurity and then how HR, okay, can protect personal data. So anyway, our guest for today actually is an old timer. Okay, we've guested him last year and then it's his second time. We have Jan Michael ESPINO. Okay, so Jan, what's up?
Hi, good evening, Chris and Ken. Thank you for having me again. We all know that we're in the middle of another COVID surge, so a lot of us are probably still working from home.
Yeah, that's correct. So, well, right now, okay, people are either on 100% WFH or they are on a hybrid setup. Okay, so because actually, hindi talaga maiwasan yon because it's also, I have, you know, in my line of work now, okay, we have a lot of like transitioners actually. So they have been gradually, okay, choosing work from home careers, and it's because they either got scared, they actually experienced a coworker, okay, somebody sitting beside them, okay, having COVID, and then eventually they analyze that it might be a safer mode of doing work if they just remain home base. Yon. So, but with that, okay, so actually, extensively being home base has been discussed, okay, but we are going to talk about safety of data because actually before Christmas, there was an incident or there was a concern about data protection and being hacked. Because there was like a very big, a known bank, okay, that was hacked, okay. And then there were a lot of people who actually experienced, you know, a lot of like money being siphoned from their account to another account. So anyway, that's not our focus for today, but today we're just going to focus on data protection. But Jan, okay, so you co-founded Vanguard Screening.
Yes, yes.
And then you actually establish, okay, another firm, which is a cybersecurity firm. Can you tell us more about it?
Why don't you upskill in the comforts of your own home? Improve and add more certificates in your resume. Simple, direct, easy. Visit the playlist in our YouTube channel. Browse through our videos and choose the video that interests you. Send in your requests for a particular video and we will send back the certificate via email. Watch this.
Thank you.
the last time that I was here, no, we spoke about background screening, and that's the business of Vanguard Screening Solutions. So as you can imagine, Vanguard Screening Solutions, no, we do background checking of our clients, employees, and applicants. So we hold a lot of personal information, candidate information.
Mm-hmm.
And maintaining the privacy and the security of that information is paramount to our business. No? So if a background screening company like us cannot be trusted to keep our clients' as employees' information secure, then we will lose clients, right? So that's why from the start, we have been quite focused on information security, no, and data privacy. So within Vanguard, we were one of the first background, we were, I think, the first Philippine-based background screening company to be certified for ISO 27001.
Mm-hmm.
And we are one of the few in the world, actually. No? So I thought of why don't I sort of spin off that expertise
in
cybersecurity and data privacy and offer that service to other companies, no? especially Philippine companies that are not that large, that cannot afford the major players and who are quite expensive. I think our advantage is we have experience not only in the technical side, but also we have the experience in running an actual operation. So what Exeleus can bring you is not just the technical expertise, but also operational expertise. No? Because as I will show later, information security is actually everybody's concern. It's not just the IT team or the information security team. No? It has to be a full of company approach.
Well, usually kasi sa HR, okay, before data privacy, unfortunately, there are HR professionals or in the practice in the workplace, parang masyadong informal, and then we're kind of loose with the information. Yeah. Okay, I don't know if I think it's a cultural thing. Parang ito ay TMI, alam mo yon, too much information. We talk about our nephews, we talk about our family. So anyway, what are the, Jan, cybersecurity, maybe a lot of people don't understand the term. Can you define what cybersecurity is?
Yeah, so later I have a couple of slides, no? But essentially cybersecurity is protecting your organization's confidential information. It's using tools and also changing your behavior and your operational processes to make sure that information security and data privacy is basically part of your DNA. No, it should not be just an add-on. Here's our whole operation. By the way, we need to secure our information.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? It has to be, the discipline has to be there where when you design your processes and your systems, information security should be top of mind.
Okay, so this is actually HR, okay, being, well, systematic and also looking at this processes, the whole of the HR processes as one system. But anyway, let's talk about, because it's the first time from a long period of time that we reconnected, I'll just shift to Ken. So Ken, so we're talking about behavioral change, etc. So first, how are you? What have you been up to? And then what are your comments about behavioral change, especially in the time of, you know, being conscious of personal information?
Behavioral change. Sa akin naman, I've been super quiet for quite some time. Been really focused with managing some investment sa cryptocurrency space. So kaway-kaway sa mga fellow friends na umiiyak ngayon dahil bagsak yung market. Pero syempre, chill lang tayo dyan. And then, I've been focused mainly with working with people pa rin. On the side, I've been coaching some people in terms of, syempre, leadership, sa personality development. And based dun sa tanong mo, ano ulit yan, Chris? Behavioral change with
sharing personal information.
Ngayon kasi a lot of people parang ang term ba natin doon, nonchalant.
Yeah.
Medyo malalim na English yun.
Nonchalant.
kasi parang medyo chill yung mga tao with actually giving out information. Lalo na hindi nila napapansin na there were times na sobrang pag na-hack ka na, nag-iiba yung perspective eh. Nag-iiba yung perspective. Lalo na pag na-hack ka na yung nakuhanan ka na ng private information mo, lalo na yung mga documents mo. Kasi minsan sa ngayon, when they ask for, pwede mo ba isend yung ID mo? Minsan wala ka ng tanong eh. Sige, send mo na agad, front and back pa ng ID mo. Just ang mga quote and quote pa namin dyan sa mga ganyang statements is for security purposes. If I say for security purposes, it bypasses your brain. Ano lang pwede pa pa-send po ng ano ng ID niyo for security reasons. Bigla ikaw, sige. Wala, minsan wala ka ng tanong doon eh. Tama? Pero again, why are we sharing this? So that you become more aware of it. Because when you're aware of it, you could actually make something. We could make that decision for change, di ba? So, yun lang yung napansin natin ngayon. With there's too much running on the internet and in our heads right now, sometimes we forget our own personal security with our information.
Well, actually, yung personal information, kasi I think like, you know, I'm actually quite conscious of information that I share about myself. So if you notice, I just concentrate on Facebook, I just concentrate on this advocacy, okay? And then on my personal page, I just concentrate on sharing pictures of food, okay? So that's what I just do, okay? But because I've quite grown conscious of like some people do stalk you, oh, diba?
Tama yun, Chris. Adding to that, di ba ang hilig ng mga tao ngayon mag-post kung nasan sila? Tapos kinatakpan nila yung location nila. So if there's a person stalking you, alam nila kung nasan ka eh. Yeah. Alam nila kung nasan ka. Yeah, so people should either, I know it's a social media age right now and it's like social norm to post where you are, lalo na kung social yung status ng lugar. Diba? Pero again, you have to be careful about that. Yeah.
Well, actually, on those things, because when we, like, for example, okay, like you go on vacation, I don't post pictures during the vacation. I post after. Okay. That's one of the security measures I've done. But anyhow, okay, we don't want to water down Jan's presentation. Okay. So anyway, those are like really just like practical tips, okay, on how to safeguard your privacy. But anyway, we will give the floor to Mr. Jan Espino for his point of view and perspective on cybersecurity and HR data protection. So we will give the floor to Jan.
Yeah, I will share a PowerPoint presentation. Can you verify if you can see it already?
Yes, it is.
Do you see the entire screen or I think you may be...
I see the presentation. It's like Exeleus.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, sorry. I'll just remove my second monitor.
the second monitor.
Oh, ngayon na ano kasi, nako-confuse. Okay, yeah. Okay.
So yeah. Okay, so we see it full screen. Yes.
Yeah, so bigger na. Yeah, so actually cybersecurity and data privacy, no? This is a very wide or a very I have a standard presentation that we use in our office, you know, when we train or when we give like a seminar to our employees. It takes more than an hour. So I tried to shorten it a little bit and make it more general. And if you have some questions, so we can just tackle them as I discuss. So first, I think we have to define what is information. Let's go through the basics first, no? So what is information? Information is actually an asset. It has value, no? If a particular piece of data has no value, then hindi siya information, okay? But information, especially in an organization, usually has value and needs to be protected, just like when we protect other assets, no, like physical assets. No, so is information the same as data? Technically speaking, they're not. Data is just a collection of facts or figures, a number, a date, an address, no. It has really no value, but when you organize that data, it becomes information. Then that's when it acquires some value. So where can you find information? It can be found in different forms: paper documents, digital documents, meaning in soft copy, online or in the internet, no, on websites or forums or search sites, and also verbal communication, no. What is communication? No, it's exchanging information, diba? So information can be found in different forms. Now let's quickly go through the types of information. Imagine, no, the whole universe of information out there. So we will talk about a subset called confidential information. Okay? Because not all information is confidential. Now, there's an even smaller subset within confidential called personal information. And then there's an even smaller subset called sensitive personal information. Okay? So let's go through them one by one. And then the rest is basically just public information. So now let's discuss first public information. Public information is information that is available to the public or is readily given to anyone. Like, for example, what's your name? What's your company's name? Your office address? Your line of business? No? These are all publicly available information. Now, let's go to confidential information. So what is confidential information? It's something that, if leaked or compromised, can either harm the business or the organization. For example, if your strategies or your pricing gets leaked, that could be used by your competitors, right? So competitive advantage siya. Or it could violate the right to data privacy of a person. So now, when we say confidential, it could be about the company or about a person. If it's about a person, it's now called personal information. So now let's go to personal information. It is data, if taken together, can be used to identify an individual. As I said earlier, if you just say a name, John Espino, it doesn't really mean anything. If you say a date, which happens to be my birth date, by itself, it doesn't mean anything. It's just a random date, right? But if you put them together, it becomes personal information. So for example, we have here 5 pieces of data. It's a name, a series of 9 numbers, an address, a date, a letter, 2 letters, and 6 numbers. So individually, they really don't mean anything, eh, diba? It's just one name. So technically, Alex De La Cruz, that's really not personal information because there are so many Alex De La Cruzes in the world, right? But if you combine them together and then say that they refer to one person, this group now is considered personal information because it can identify a specific person. Alex De La Cruz, who resides in this address, has this birth date, this SSS number, and this passport number. So this is already personal information. Now, let's go to sensitive information. So let's go back to the personal information. You know, we can add more info about this person. Religion, ethnicity, political affiliation, financial records, educational credentials, or health records. So now, or even criminal and employment records. No, so the last 6 here can be considered sensitive personal information. So why sensitive? Sensitive because if somebody or another party gets to know that information about me, I can be a victim of embarrassment or unfairness or discrimination, right? For example, if a certain person has say a disease, no, if a potential employer gets to know that that person has that disease, they may not consider him or her. So that's already discrimination, especially if that person can still perform that job. No? So this type of information now becomes sensitive personal information. So you might be thinking, why do we need to why do we need to identify what's sensitive, what's personal? Later, when we discuss data privacy law, that will become very important. Okay. So let's review. No? So you have confidential information. And then there's a subset called personal information. And then there's a smaller subset called sensitive personal information. The rest is public information. So now let's discuss those that are in the shaded blue areas. So now, some people might confuse information security and data privacy. Are they the same? Do they refer to the same thing? InfoSec and data privacy. Actually, they don't. They don't, no? They're different. They're different, but they complement each other. So let's first discuss what information security is. So as I said earlier, InfoSec refers to any processes, methodologies, or tools that are used to protect information from unauthorized access, destruction, or modification. So you can just focus on the words highlighted in red, no? It's protecting information from unauthorized access, destruction, and modification. Okay. So there are three principles of information security. One is confidentiality. And for most people, when you say information security, they only think of confidentiality, no? Confidentiality means information must only be accessible to those who have authorized, who have authorization. You know? So, in short, if you don't have any right to access that data, you should not be able to access that data. Diba? It's confidentiality. For most people, that's information security or data privacy. It's confidentiality. But it's just one part of it. The second part is integrity. Now, the information that you keep in your company, if it remains confidential, fine. But if it's not accurate naman, it's of no use, right? So information security also involves the integrity of the data. Lastly, it should be available. I'll give you an example. Ano? What if you're a victim of yung hacking where your entire laptop is encrypted, diba? So if you think about it, the data in your laptop is still kept confidential. Hindi pa nako-compromise. So confidentiality, okay. Hindi naman siya binabago, so integrity is okay. But hindi pa naman siya ma-access, so hindi siya available sa'yo. So that's still an information security breach, right? Kasi useless pa rin sa yung information kasi hindi mo naman makuha. So basically, when we say InfoSec, it's making sure your information is available, is confidential, is kept confidential, and the integrity is kept intact. Meaning, hindi siya nababago without you knowing it. So basically, InfoSec is protecting our information from threats. Okay? Protecting our information from threats. So what are threats? A threat is anything, a circumstance, a situation, or an event that could potentially impact your organization or your personal data. Okay? So InfoSec is making sure that the chances of successful threats are minimized and also the damage to your data or to your information when a successful threat happens is also minimized. No? So, I think we have to assume that we will get hacked sometime, no? Actually, probably chances are your company is being hacked right now, successfully. Okay? There's no such thing as unhackable organization. Even the US government gets hacked sometimes, right? So the threats are there and they're happening continuously. So what when we say infosec, it's minimizing the chances that they are successful. But again, it could not, you cannot guarantee zero successful ano, hacking attempts, no. So minimize lang the threat and minimize the impact of any successful threat. So that's the essence of information security. So let's just go through some examples of threats, no. So one, confidentiality. For example, very common when you accidentally send an email to the wrong person, no, and that email contains confidential information. That's already an incident. Okay? Kasi that I assume that wrong person does not have authorization to see that data, right? So if you mistakenly send the email to him or her, that's already a breach. Or another common incident, no? You print something that's confidential, say a CV of an applicant, and then you forgot to retrieve the printout. So somebody can see it, right? So, or gamitin mo scratch paper, no? Or sharing confidential information verbally, no? Chismis or kwento. That's already infosec breach. You put confidential files in a USB drive, and then it's not encrypted, and then you lose that drive or nanakaw, no? Nadukutan ka, and then na-access ng ibang tao. That's another breach in confidentiality. And then, of course, we have the hackers, no, gaining access. So, for most people, ang laging iniisip, na-hack. For example, yung na-mention kanina, yung sa bank, yung issue sa bank, na-hack yung bank. Actually, hindi na-hack yung bank. Hindi siya na-hack. Hindi na-hack yung network ng bank. Ang nangyari doon, they basically gamed the system, but they were not able to hack the system of that bank. Okay. Hacking of the system of a big company is not that does not happen quite often, no?
Mm-hmm.
Pero maraming mga incidences ng cybersecurity breaches. And nangyayari yon hindi dahil sa napasukan nila, na-hack nila yung firewall ng bank. It's because yung tao, nag-game nila yung tao. Niloko nila yung mga tao. Or merong tao na careless. So, may mga data na nagsabi na vast majority ng mga cybersecurity breaches happen not because of yung system na na-hack. Dahil magaling talaga yung hacker. Technically, magaling. Hindi. It's carelessness of people. Okay?
I think this has something to do with, like, for example, yung pinaka-example dyan, just to, I actually, during November, October, November, I kept getting text messages, okay? Like, I'm a recruiter, I'm an HR manager, if you want to apply.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, there's a link here. Eh, syempre, being somebody who hasn't been applying because I'm already employed, yes, nagtaka ako bakit may ganito. So, I just ignored. And yes, then, after mga around 2 weeks, nakita ko na yung story nung na-hack na back. I think that's what happened there. Like, there was like a random marketing message or somebody asked you to fill out an online form. Akala mo may promo. Something like that, I think. Is that phishing?
Yeah, that's phishing, but I don't think that's related to the bank.
Okay.
Anyway, hindi ko alam.
This is just a speculation. Actually, being a bystander, okay, yeah, sure. So when that story erupted, I actually, this is like a very, this is like from a novice detective, okay? Because actually, what happened, I experienced like from October, November, like a series of text messages na enticing you to apply to this position, or et cetera, et cetera. And then after that, nakita ko na merong
isa ba yung mga issue,
May mga issues na on Facebook. Kasi I'm involved naman in, heavily monitoring Facebook naman. So I saw that issue. So I kind of like put maybe I shouldn't be, yun na nga yung, ano, yung importance of not sharing your information, or basta-basta ka na lang mag-fill up ng online form for a promo. Mm. So yeah, that's one of the security measures like I actually follow.
Yeah. So just to share one story, no? So one of the most famous hacks na ginawa, actually parang, ano na to, part of cyber war na to, no? And there have been books and TV documentaries that were made regarding this particular hack. So hinack ng America yung Iran, ano, yung Iran nuclear program. Napasukan nila and then kinontrol nila yung mga centrifuges ng Iran para masira, no. So basically ganon. So if you think about it, paano nila napasukan? Dahil ba magaling yung hacker ng America at saka ng Israel? Actually ganito lang yun eh. Nilagay nila yung kanilang pang-hack na software sa isang USB. And then kinalat-kalat nila kung saan dumadaan-daan yung mga scientists ng Iran. Isa sa mga scientists, kinuha yung USB na yon. Tapos tinignan niya, uy, kaya to? Sinaksak niya sa kanyang PC. So na-transfer yung malware from the USB sa PC ng scientist. So nakapasok na yun yung US at nahack nila yung sa Iran, no. So it's really mostly reliant on human error and human to use the word kanina, yung nonchalance, no. Uy, ano to? Ayan. So anyway, so other potential threats is yung tinatawag ko na integrity, meaning pag merong nagkamali sa pagde-data enter, for example, nagkamali ng enter ng birth date, na confuse ang month at saka yung day. So that's also an integrity threat kasi mali na yung data mo about that person, di ba? Or pag may nagka-copy-paste sa dalawang Excel sheet, nagkamali, integrity threat yan. O kaya pwede rin intentional. Of course. Or yung nagiging corrupt yung file, no? So that's another information security threat. And then lastly, we have availability. Ito yung pag hindi mo na ma-access. Na-delete mo, o kaya may virus ka na encrypt, di ba? O kaya nag-crash yung hard disk, o kaya down yung network. These are also considered information security breaches kasi hindi mo ma-access yung data mo, di ba? Pag kailangan mo. And then of course, yung mga hacker na yung dini-DOS nila. So now, that's information security. So now, what's data privacy? Okay, data privacy actually is mandated by a law. Okay. Sa Philippines, it's governed by the Data Privacy Act of 2012, no? And then may IRR na pinas a few years ago. So, data privacy is mandated by laws. Okay? And it's applicable to any person, Filipino or not, or any company, Filipino-owned or not, operating in the Philippines. Okay? And then, other countries, I think most countries may sarili-sarili ng data privacy laws, ano, which are mostly similar sa Philippine Data Privacy Act. Okay. So, kanina I mentioned, no, InfoSec is protecting your information. Data privacy naman, it's on how data should be used. Collected, stored, managed, and shared. And that use should comply with the data privacy law. So, pag InfoSec, protecting the confidentiality, integrity, and availability of your information. Data privacy is using other people's data, basically, the right way. And it's mandated by laws. So, yun ang fundamental difference ng InfoSec and data privacy. Sa data privacy, meron tayong apat, no? Yung tinatawag na transparency, legitimate purpose, proportionality, and data quality. So I'll quickly run through these four. Kasi importante to kasi pwede tayong lumabag sa batas at makasuhan pag na-violate natin ang data privacy, no? Anong sinasabi ng first principle na transparency? You need to have the consent of the person before you collect his data. And kailangan mo siyang i-inform kung para saan pag kino-collect mo yung data. For example, when someone is applying to your company and then gusto mo siyang i-background check. Kami sa Vanguard screening, before namin iba-background check yung candidate ng kliyente namin, that we need to have a signed authorization form from the candidate. Sinasabi niyang, basically, sinasabi niyang, yes, alam ko kung ba't niyo kailangan ng data ko. Nakalagay doon, gagamitin namin to for background screening. Okay, so kailangan malinaw, may informed consent yung candidate. Okay? Informed dapat siya, aware siya dapat sa mga risk, and kaya niya dapat na questionin. Okay? Bakit kailangan to nagawin? And kailangan masagot siya. So this is actually what the law is saying. Dito sa Philippines, I'm sure marami pa lumalabag sa ganito eh, dahil hindi pa masyadong aware yung mga tao na may right sila to question. No? So that's the first principle, transparency. Second, yung legitimate purpose. For example, papasok ako sa isang building, di ba? Maglalagin ako, hinihingi pangalan ko, company, and my cellphone number. Right? So, ba't ko kailangan ilagay yon? Kailangan pwede kong questionin yung guard, no? So, yun ngayon sa transparency. Ba't mo kinukuha to? Masasabihin nila, sir, para reference namin kung sakaling may magkaroon ng issue. Okay, sige. So, punta tayo ngayon, no? So, sinabi naman nila, di ba, na kailangan namin yon para to make sure na kung merong magka-problema, pwede nilang kontakin yung visitor. Okay, fine. Okay, fine. Pero ngayon ito, yung proportionality. Dapat, yung listahan na yon hindi magagamit sa ibang purposes like telemarketing. Right? Yung mga sign-up sheets sa mga conference, mag-attend ka ng conference or a seminar, they ask you to sign, right? Name, company, position, email address, cellphone number. So if you ask them, why do you need this? Sasabihin nila, for attendance lang po. Okay, binigay mo. Hindi nila pwedeng gamitin yun for telemarketing purposes. The law says they cannot use that for any other purpose except yung dineclare nila na for attendance lang. But as we all know in the Philippines, madaming ganyan eh. Pag-a-attend ka na seminar. I'm sure the next day makaka-receive ka ng mga ano no yung sa email mo no ng mga services, yung mga offer of services. That's illegal. That's not only unprofessional or unethical, it's actually illegal now. Okay? So that's proportionality. Finally, there's the data quality. This is like the integrity eh no. So if you're collecting personal data, dapat naman you keep it accurate. Complete and up to date. So, yun ang sinasabi niya. Okay? So, now, before we leave this, InfoSec and data privacy, again, how do they compare? They're not the same. Okay? InfoSec, it's securing your information from threats. Data privacy is all about gathering and using data or information responsibly. So, magkaiba siya. There are three principles in InfoSec. Confidentiality, integrity, availability. You need to ensure that your information is kept confidential, integrity is kept, and is always available when needed. Data privacy, you must have transparency, meaning you should tell the person no, why you are collecting his or her information, for what purpose. It must be used only for the purpose that you told them, and the data should be kept accurate. So, InfoSec is guided by company policies and guidelines. Wala pa naman talagang batas na magsasabi na dapat yung HR records mo, meron kang level na protection nila. For example, there's no law saying that your company should use an antivirus program, should have a network firewall, should have an Active Directory installed. Walang ganung law. All these are best practices, right? And they're guided by company policies and guidelines. In contrast, data privacy, we don't have any choice because the law imposes that we follow data privacy guidelines. So InfoSec, it's guided by company policies and guidelines and best practices. Data privacy, it's guided by law. Meaning, pwede tayong makulong or ma-fine or makulong and ma-fine ng malaki when you don't follow data privacy laws. Okay? So now, why do we need to protect our data or information? No? If you think about it, all businesses ngayon, when they make a decision, you need data, eh, di ba? How many people do I need to hire? Let's look at our demand data, no? How do we price our services? Let's look at the data, di ba? How are we performing? Let's look at the data. Okay. We are in the age of information. So, especially for companies like, for example, Vanguard Screening, we don't produce any tangible product, di ba? We are an information processing company. So, it's our lifeblood. Okay, so protecting it is very important. And which means yung actual viability ng isang company, ng isang business, pwedeng ma-threaten yan. For example, if a bank's records or let's say you're using a particular online job board. And then somehow that job board ma-hack and all the data in that job board gets compromised. Will you still use that same job board? Maybe you would think about using another job board, right? Because hindi pala secure ang data ko dito, eh, di ba? Just like, kung madaling ma-hack yung isang company, as in talagang nahahack siya, yung isang bank, you would probably consider, using another bank. Okay? So now, let's just quickly... So, what are the various types of information assets of a company, no? Employee records, sales records, customer information, supplier, financial, ang dami, no? Iba-ibang klaseng information yan. But let's concentrate on employee records kasi especially HR tayo ngayon, ano? Ano-ano yung employee records, no? Yung name, birth date, address, etc. ng employees natin and mga applicants, SSS, BIR, mga grades, employment history and salary, performance records, biometric information, health information. Lahat yan nasa 201 file, di ba? So, it can be found in when we collect CVs or application forms in our applicant tracking system, 201, ganun. In emails, in our PCs, in our file servers, and even in text messages, no? Or if you're doing call recording, they can be found also in yung mga call records. So remember, napag-usapan natin kanina, yung personal information, confidential yan. It's confidential information. So why is that important? The Philippine Data Privacy Law specifically says that personal information and sensitive personal information cannot be disclosed, di ba? Without yung sinabi ko kanina, no? Yung consent, transparency, etc. So, HR people actually are most affected with the data privacy law because they are the custodians of employee records. And employees are people, no? So data privacy law applies to them. By the way, is corporate or non-employee records governed by the data privacy law? Actually, hindi nga eh. The data privacy law is all about personal information. It's all about personal information. If you leak yung financial records ng isang company, that's not actually in violation of the data privacy law. The data privacy law is all about personal information. Personal information. Who's the custodian of personal information in any company? The HR person, the HR manager, or whoever, the payroll master. Depende, no, kung gaano kalaki yung company. So, the data privacy law is really impactful sa part ng mga HR people. Okay? So now, quickly, how do we protect company information then? So, cybersecurity is basically the technology, the process, and the practice to protect your information. That's cybersecurity. Pero when you say cybersecurity, most people kasi iniisip yung technical solutions, eh, mga firewall, antivirus, ganyan. Mayroong mga lock yung buildings namin, etc. May CCTV. But it's actually multi-layered defense, no? Meron tayong procedural, behavioral, and technical. So let's go through it one by one. Behavioral first. Behavioral, basically, we need to all keep in mind that threats are always present and we need to act accordingly. Like yung napag-discussionan kanina nyo ni Ken, di ba? Yung personal naman to, pero natin sa company, pero not posting where you are right now on social media. No, yung behavioral eh, that's behavioral. So, like sabi ko kanina, yung behavioral, yung pagsisend, yung nagkamali ka ng pagsend ng email na send mo, meron kang employee list, nandun yung pangalan nila, birth date, sweldo, position. Tapos na-email mo sa ibang tao. So na-leak na kagad yung information, di ba? So that's behavioral, okay?
Yes, and also like during Christmas, yung mga nagpo-post na may bonus ako, 13th month pay. Yes. Okay, so actually you're rendering, okay, so you're trying to compliment probably the company, yes, or you really sound excited. But if you think about it to the criminal mind, okay, you will actually render yourself vulnerable or volatile to them.
Sure.
Kasi binigyan mo ng clue na may pera ka.
Oo, oh, uy, na-release na yung pera, no? Na-release na yung bonus, ganun, thank you, ganun. So, yun. And then, of course, yung procedural, no? So, procedural naman is that the company should have procedures or policies in place, no? Yung best practices in place that would help drive the behavior of the company. For example, one of the most important thing is using a good password. Yung password na complicated, hindi password. Halimbawa sa company mo, sabihin mo sa mga tao mo, oh, huwag nyo nang gagawin yung ang password nyo, 4 characters lang at puro letters.
Or birthday ninyo.
Oh, ngayon, okay, sige, sasabihin mo yon. Pero yung system mo naman, tinatanggap niya yon. Di ba? Tinatanggap niya yung simple. So, paano, di ba? So, if you tell them na don't use very simple passwords, behavioral, and then procedural, your system, your application systems should also ensure that walang choice yung employee mo but to use a good password, di ba? Kasi you cannot guarantee na, magbago na kayo, change your behavior, don't use easy-to-guess passwords. Pero your system naman, your procedures, allow the use of simple passwords. Wala rin, may hirapan ka. So they should all work hand in hand. The behavioral, then the procedural. You need to have a procedure in place, no? Kailangan ba train mo sila? Your procedure is you need to change your password every 30 days. It has to be 12 characters, etc., etc. So, mapipilitan sila ngayon. Their behavior will have to adapt to that procedure, di ba? And then, once you have the procedure, yung bang server mo, kaya niyang i-implement yung procedure mo. For example, sa'yo mo, bawal magdala ng cellphone sa operations floor. That's behavioral. Ang procedure mo ngayon, ganito. Pagpapasok ka, iiwan mo sa locker. Kung wala ka namang locker, sasabihin ng empleyado mo, saan ko itong iiwan, boss? Di ba? At saka, meron ka ngayong procedure na mag-inspect yung, for example, yung guard or whatever, na talagang iniiwan nila yung kanilang cellphone sa locker. That's procedural. And then, anong technical? Pwede kang may CCTV to check. So, they should all go hand in hand, di ba? Hindi lang pure technical ang cybersecurity. It should be behavioral, procedural, and technical. So, bottom line, who is responsible for protecting your organization's information assets? Is it your CEO? Is it your CTO? Is it your head of HR? Is it your InfoSec director? No, it's you. Everyone is responsible. Okay? Everyone. Yung bang janitor nyo, alam na huwag magtatapon sa labas ng documents na potentially may confidential information. Diba? Alam ba nila na dapat na may shredding machine kayo? meron ba kayong shredding machine? I-shred lahat. May procedure ba na nagsasabing lahat dapat i-shred? Diba? So, I will end my presentation here, ano? Kasi pwede pa tayong humaba ng humaba na lang time. Pero, basically, in an organization, cybersecurity is everyone's responsibility. Hindi siya isang team lang, hindi yung IT team lang siya. Okay? So, yan.
So, thank you, John. So, I agree, actually, information security is actually a team effort, okay, all departments. In fact, I remember may mga procedures set, okay? So, I used to be, you know, HR admin. So, pag HR admin ka kasi, you're thinking of these things, okay? Kasi, pati yung IT, well, there was a point in my career, I was HR admin head, and then pati yung IT under sa akin.
Yeah.
Well, there's a, hindi yung buong IT, but yung information security. So, anyhow, okay, so, it's actually a holistic view of cybersecurity, and we'd like to greet everyone who is watching our FB Live presentation this evening. So, hello everyone. Okay, nice to see you again. Okay, and then as we go along, okay, our discussion, okay, you can post your questions. Anyhow, Jan, okay, so this one you mentioned that this is like, you can actually have a simple approach to information security, and it can be, you know, from a behavioral perspective. This is simply yes. Okay, so in your business, okay, so can you emphasize, okay, or give more examples about things that are being neglected by Filipino employees?
Yeah, so some more examples, no? And I'll give more an example na, no, yung office-based, okay? Na-mention ko na kanina, no, yung nagpiprint and then kinakalimutan na kunin. So, ipiprint ko tong payroll form. And then, may nakichika sa'yo, no? So, nandun lang sa printer ng 10 minutes, no? And or nagtitipid environmentally conscious, let's reuse paper. Okay, and this really happens a lot, ano, and pag tiningnan mo, ano, nandun pala yung job offer, so nandun na yung sweldo, di ba? So that's one. And what else, no, yung behavior na sharing passwords.
Mm-hmm.
So that's very common, ano, when you share a password, kasi yung ginagawa namin sa office, kumbaga nasa policy namin ganito. If an email is sent using your account, we will assume that it came from you.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
Yes. Ngayon, kung sasabihin mo hindi ako yan, kailangan ikaw mag-prove na hindi ikaw yon. Which is, you know, medyo mahirap, but mali mo nga naman. Pero i-assume namin na galing sa'yo. Meaning, responsable ka dyan, huwag mong isi-share sa iba. Diba?
Actually, that happened. Actually, we had that case, not in my present company, but in my past company. Okay. Sumagot siya. It was about accepting terms. Kasi this one, for termination siya. And then accepting terms of that termination has something to do with what can be, deducted from the salary, from the final pay. Since nag-confirm siya, tapos may document naman na may signature niya. So it was sent via email. Then that person denied it.
Yeah, mahirap yun, no?
Yeah, but since, because by logic, since there was a signature, diba, it's like a holographic, diba, print, and then it came from your email, then we will assume it's from you.
Yeah. Also, may mga nangyayari din na nakikita yung mga HR data kasi nakashare sa isang file server na hindi password protected. O kaya yung, if you're using, for example, Active Directory, no, yung...
Usually, if there's a CRM or portal, hindi nila alam, hindi alam ng HR yung viewing blueprint. So, nakikita pala ng iba.
Yes. So dapat laging, susunod tayo dun sa concept na, least privilege. Yung least privilege na, as an employee, kung ano ang trabaho ko, kung ano lang yung kailangan ko na para sa trabaho ko, yun lang yung dapat ma-access ko. For example, if I'm a programmer, hindi ko naman dapat ma-access yung ano, yung payroll records, right? Mm-hmm. If I'm say sa BPO, call center agent, hindi ko dapat ma-access yung data ni IT o yung data ni HR, di ba? And vice versa. So, dapat ganun yung concept.
Jan, meron kasi akong sagot dyan. Pinakasimpleng sagot sa mga taong gusto makakita ng mga sweldo. Kung ayaw nyo masaktan, huwag kayo tumingin sa ibang
yes. sweldo. Totoo yun. No? Pero alam naman natin na yung behavior ng tao, hindi. Di ba? Kasi, siguro, meron kang 100 employees. Maybe 95, ganun ang... Sabi mo nang 95 kung swerte ka, nagkaroon ng thinking. Ba't meron ka pa rin 5?
Diba? Kasi ito yung pag sinabi ko, kung ayaw nyo masaktan, hindi ito yung physical threat. In other words,
yeah, tama yun.
Kung ayaw nyo yung, huwag kayong masokista, kung ayaw nyo yung mag-hurt, yes. yung damdamin nyo, huwag nyo na tingnan yung kay Pedro at Juan yes. and you can just exactly. concentrate on yourself. Di ba, Ken? Make sense?
Yes, it does make sense, pero gagawin at gagawin ng mga tao.
Kasi juicy, di ba?
Exactly. Alam naman natin na gagawin niya. Isa pa yung ano, isa pa siguro yung pag nag-resign na, minsan nag-resign na ng, minsan anim na buwan ng resign, may access pa rin. Lalo na ngayon, di ba, naka-remote, malamang baka naka-VPN pa. Nag-resign nung October, baka ngayon makaka-login pa siya sa VPN ng company mo, di ba? So, kailangan, no, yun ang mga kailangan mong gawan ng ano eh, ng mga procedures na susundan ng mga tao nyo to make sure na, ano, so, yun ang mga pwede, for example, kami, yun ang pwede naming ma-advise or matulungan yung mga ibang companies to put up yung necessary na ano muna, na parang procedures, guidelines, yeah. ma-analyze work kung saan systems. Ba yung exposure nyo, ganon. And then, saka na yung ano eh, yung mga technical solutions, yung mga firewall na sinasabi, parang ano yan, obviously medyo mahal yun, ano? Kung baka naman kasi 90% ng problema mo ngayon ma-address ng change in behavior and policy lang. And then, siyempre, yung 10%, kung kailangan mong gas tusan ng malaki, kailangan mo rin yung risk, di ba? For example, ang risk na makakakog from outside, ang mawala sa akin, 1 million pesos, ang cost to put up yung firewall, 2 million pesos, okay na siguro na makakakog. Parang ganun, di ba? Dahil mas mahal pa yung bibiling ko, di ba?
It's actually cost benefits analysis, yeah, but so, really, what it starts from yes. really behavioral change, okay, and yeah, also yung ano, being more aware of the dangers of the information being leaked by parties that parang actually that can abuse the access to information.
Oh, pwede. Yung common din yung ano. Late. Gagawin ko to sa weekend sa bahay. Email ko yung payroll file sa aking personal email. Tapos para i-access ko sa bahay ko, di ba? So,
actually, common yan ngayon.
Because, common talaga.
Kasi especially now, that's why when, kasi ito lang yung guideline from a systematic point of view. It actually, parang when you onboard employees and then when you exit, when they go to an exit process, there has to be really a formal structure para you make sure that they get into the system properly and then they are managed out properly.
Yeah, and kailangan matanggalan sila ng mga accounts ng access no at the right time. So ideally yan, the moment na ma-separate siya, tanggalan mo na. Okay, yung mga iba nga, the moment nag-file ng resignation eh. Pwede mo nang bawasan yung access niya.
That's correct. Diba? And then on a personal level, okay, John and Ken, okay, so ito yung nonchalance. Okay, nonchalance. Okay, so ako kasi, I don't really share information because number one, especially if you are in recruitment, so alam naman natin as an HR professional, we are stalkers ourselves, okay? So actually, what we advise people, and also when I coach people on their careers, I always say that whatever you share publicly should, since you are actively, on the career path, you should be more conscious of building your own personal brand. So I always say that. But kayo Ken, ikaw, ano yung mga volatile points na nakikita mo aside from the vacation and whatever?
Sa akin kasi I do parang on I'm on both sides eh. Parang stalker din ako kasi pag ano yung sinasabi mo kanina, Chris, in regards dun sa pag I need to check on a behavior or a personality ng isang client ko, I have to stalk them.
Kasi public, so, shared naman
public
siya.
Eh, public eh. So, ang dami ko tinitingnan dyan. This is on a different note, guys. Ah. So, from Twitter, Instagram, tinitingnan ko yung main social media nila. Kasi iba-iba tayo ng, ano, ng focus ng social media. A lot of people get to focus on just Facebook alone. So with Facebook alone, are you posting publicly or privately? Tama? Titignan ko yung common friends. Kasi pag chinek mo yung mga photos yan, makikita, hindi mo makikita yan pag wala kang common friends eh. Oh. Diba? Pero pag may common friends kayo, yung mga pictures na nakatag sila dun, kita mo kagad. Tapos nakikita mo kagad yung choices ng tao. Kasi on a behavioral perspective, you choose what you're wearing right now, that's a decision eh. The colors you pick, meron yan eh. Mapapansin mo, ah, ito, favorite color nito. Everything is information on how I see things. Tama? So, a lot of information are easily posted on Facebook, lalo na on Instagram. And, mas lalo na, mas nakikita ang behavior ng tao sa Twitter. Kasi sa Twitter, mostly, that's an app in where you post emotions eh.
Mm-hmm.
What you feeling at the moment, lumindol ngayon, lindol, lumilindol ngayon, dun, you post it there, right? So, ako, kaya napaka-importante na sinishare ni Jan kanina. Kasi nakikita ko dun, isa dun sa tinake note ko sa sinabi was yung sa personal information eh. Mm-hmm. Hindi yun magiging talagang personal information mo kung hindi yun magkakasama-sama. Kung January 12, 1998 lang yun, that's just, wala lang yun. Pero pag pinagsama mo yung pangalan, yung picture, yung ano, that is already... vital personal information. Tama ba dyan? Tama, no? Yung
Tama. Tama yun. Kasi nga, sabi mo ngayon, January 12, 1998, it's just a random day.
It's just a random
day. And kahit sabi mong birthday yon, ang daming pinanganak na tao nung araw na yon, di ba?
Ang dami. So that's why nung sinabi mo yung kanina, okay. And that makes a lot of sense, no? Pag pinagsama-sama mo nga naman, that makes a person. Pero, napansin ko, based dun sa sinabi mo, yung sensitive, tama ba? Sensitive personal information, yung
yes,
mga religion, ethnicity, yung ganun. Kasi pag ako nalalaman ko yon, that tells me the behavior of the person already. So, I'm a persuasion specialist. I have to research, ano ba yung religion nito? Because if I know the person's religion or his choices with this politics and everything, I could instantly manipulate the person because I could easily tell his behavior, his values already.
And that is why it's called sensitive personal information.
Yun, yeah.
And that is why there's a special provision for it sa batas natin. Kasi mas hindi siya pwedeng i-divulge. Pero di ba, dito ngayon, very common. For example, nagtatanong sa mga ibang
CBM Lenny, lalo na pag politics, bro. Di ba?
For example, ngayon, yung mga CVs na minsan nag-apply, bakit nandun pa rin yung religion? Kasi old school eh, di ba? Nagtatanong pa rin tayo sa application form sa mga companies, may religion pa rin. Ba't malaman? Di ba? So, yung ganun pa rin dapat yung practice na marami pa rin sa HR community, hindi pa rin naalis yung ba't mo kailangan malaman kung ilan ang kapatid ko? Ba't mo kailangan malaman kung anong religion ko? Di ba? Ang kailangan mo lang naman malaman sa atin is anong pinag-aralan ko, ganyan, di ba? Kung ano experience ko sa trabaho, di ba? Kaya ko bang gawin yung trabaho na ina-applyan ko, ino-offer mo sa akin, di ba? So, kailangan, yung ganong mindset na, ito, concrete example, kahapon or 2 days ago, may tumawag na telco, no? Yung provider ko sa bahay, no? So, sabi niya, sir, may upgrade, dagdag ka na ng 100 pesos, magta times 3. So okay, di ba?
Okay.
So of course. So sige. Sir, i-verify ko lang. Pwede mo sabihin yung birth? Sabi ko, hindi kasi tinawagan mo lang ako using a cellphone. Ba't ko sasabihin? Kasi, di ba? At saka unang-una, ba't mo kailangan ng birth date ko? Ano kaya laman noon? alam mo naman makakapagbayad ako, di ba? Ng ano, ng subscription.
Anong relation nito sa repair or maintenance? Diba? Arang, ano, for
may,
me kasi,
may, ano.
So, may tinatanong ako.
Hindi usually. Ko binigay.
Oo, kasi usually pag tumawag sa akin, tapos tinatanong yung personal, kasi yun nga, yung aking reaction, ikaw yung tumawag sa akin, dapat alam mo kung sino yung tinatawagan mo. Kaya hindi ako na binababaan ko talaga yon.
How do you approach that for the both of you? How do you approach that kind of situation? I mean, a lot of people would just get to trust the person on the other line. Lalo na kung magaling mag-framing yung tao on the phone, di ba? Ah, sir, I just want to verify, di ba, sir? Just to confirm your name. Iko-confirm ko muna yung name. Mr. Blah, 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 blah. And your email is, could you confirm your email with us? Mm. Ikaw naman may ibit ka na dun eh.
Yeah.
So how do you approach that? Should you give it right away? Or is there an approach to that na babalik na rin mo ba? Well, I think you have the data on your records. Maybe you could confirm my email.
Ako binabaliktad ko. Kasi sinasabi ko, ikaw yung tumawag sa akin. So why should I verify my, ano, my yeah. why should I give it that to you?
Pwede balik ta rin.
So why don't you give me your phone number, your local, and then I will give me your employee number.
Yeah, yung sa akin naman, like, ganun nga, parang, you have ano eh, di ba? So, tinawagan niya ako. So, dapat alam niya na ako yon, and then nag-confirm ako. And since galing siya halimbawa doon sa telco na yon, alam na niya yung records ko, di ba? Sabi mo nga, dapat sabihin mo sa akin, iko-confirm ko kung tama. Bakit hindi, dapat ganun, di ba? And also, another tip din, tingnan mo ano pinatawag sa yung phone number. Kung mukha siyang trunk line na 8888-0000, and then pwede mo i-verify siguro, quickly i-browse mo, ano bang trunk line nitong company na to. Kung yun ang trunk line, so medyo ano ka ng konti na galing to dun sa trunk line ng company. Pero hindi kami 100%. Pero may konting confidence level ka. Pero again, para sa akin, yung best practice should be, kung meron siyang kailangan i-confirm sa'yo, nasa kanya na yung information na yun eh, di ba? Siya yung magsasabi dapat sa'yo. And then, i-confirm mo.
Yes so, like, or no pa lang.
Dapat ganun. So, ang sa akin, yung ginawa ko yung call, sabi ko, hindi ko talaga sasasabihin. So, paano na to, sabi ko? Gusto ko mag-upgrade eh, pero, sige sir, may iba namang option. Punta kayo sa website namin, ikaw mismo mag-a-apply.
Pwede yun.
Na ako nag-apply.
That makes you more secure. Kasi ikaw na yung nag-interact with their system. And you're sure that where you're interacting with the website, mas secure nga naman. Okay.
Actually, mas heightened ang alert ko kung wala naman talaga akong tinawagan at may tumawag sa akin na gano'n. Kasi merong nangyayari na gano'n. Yung from out of the blue, may tumawag sa'yo, wala naman ikaw problema. There was like a time in 2020, may mga ganun. Kaya ang ginawa ko, pinalitan ko na lang yung landline ko.
Yeah, kaya kasi dapat ano mag-ingat lahat, diba?
Yung kasing convenience lagi, diba? Na parang, yung attack naman kasi ng mga potential na hacker o mga scammer sa'yo is yung convenience, eh. Diba parang, may isip ko na kung hindi ko bibigay yung email address ko at saka phone number, hassle pa, ganun. So bibigay mo na lang. So you need to fight off the urge na ano na mas madali kung ibigay, i-disclose ko na lang kagad.
Tsaka I have kasi it's actually how you secure yourself. Like there's an email address that I used for, you know, for online shopping and marketing purposes.
Ayan, pwede rin yan, yeah.
Parang ganun. Meron kasi akong ganun kasi hindi siya yung tipong yung talagang email address ko. Parang meron akong decoy, something like that. Kasi it's really, ako kasi, I have not actually been hacked, but I experienced the inconvenience sa bank.
Mm-hmm.
Yung there was a time in 2013, it was another bank, merong nawawalang amount sa ano mo, sa ATM mo. And then it actually will take you to, they actually will reimburse you or refund you. But the thing is, it will take like 2 to 3 weeks to do that for the amount to be returned.
Bakit nangyari yun? Meron nag-withdraw talaga o nagkaroon ng problema sa kanilang database?
They didn't explain it. Basta I noticed it and then I know that I didn't withdraw it.
Okay.
Kasi yeah, ano lang naman ako eh, may I have stable habits naman eh. So parang hindi ko winidraw to, and then kasi what I do kasi I do my own personal accounting, so I would know if I withdrew it or not. So tsaka yung ano, pina-check ko siya, I was not in the area. Kasi meron, kasi when you complain, they will verify which ano, which ATM, which area it was withdrawn from, and I was not in anywhere near that area. It was somewhere in Quiapo or something like that. So, yun.
Yeah. One more ano, no? Isa pang tip is enable nyo as much as possible yung ano, yung pag-generate ng one-time password, yung
2FA.
Yeah, 2FA or multi-factor authentication. Para kung may mag-change ng password mo, ganun, malalaman mo sa, ano mo. Although, yung ano, yung sa nangyari recently doon sa bank, yung part na yun yung na ano nila, na-compromise eh, yung OTP eh.
OTP,
so, ang maganda siguro ngayon, kung kilala ng lahat yung cellphone mo, kung matagal nang nasa'yo, nasa ano mo, nasa calling card, whatever, maybe you need to use a different phone number for your OTP. Yung phone number na private na ikaw lang o konti-konti lang yung nakakalaman. So that's another, you know, parang tip.
Yun din sasabihin ko kasi I was hacked multiple times already, even though I have my security stuff in place, di ba? So, ang laking factor yun sa mga companies nga rin na kanina na pag-usapan na parang force of habit. Pag may kinatanggal na tao, you have to actually cleanse. Talagang tatanggalin yun. Minsan kasi napapabayaan eh. Parang, okay lang yan. Di ba?
Yeah.
Pero pag may nangyaring bulilyaso, tsaka nyo lang malalaman yung importance nun eh.
Parang insurance yan eh.
Doon lang malalaman pag nandun ka na. Di ba? Kaya listen to people, experts like Jan. Kasi, I mean, very, very important yung information na pinag-uusapan natin dito. This can really help you personally and your company also save time na sa mga ibang bulilyaso rin. So yung 2FA nga, yan two-factor authentication na sinasabi, it's very, very important din. Lalo na ako, I work with the crypto space. One hack could instantly wipe out all of your money. And that happened to me in the past. I was storing some of my personal private keys, kung tawagin namin, private keys on an app called Evernote. And I got hacked sa Evernote without me having some 2FAs there. So ang nangyari, na-open nila lahat ng notepads ko and na-siphon. Every time na may pumapasok na pera doon sa Ethereum address ko, everything was siphoned kaagad. And I noticed it 2 weeks after. So parang every time na may nagpapadala ako ng pera doon, boom, wala na kaagad after a minute. So nung I got to send some money there, biglang nagulat na lang ako, nawawala na lahat ng Ethereums ko. So I mean that sort of small negligence on my end led me to lose a lot of money. So an laking factor dito, kaya ang ganda ng topic natin ngayon about your personal information ganyan, kasi we're in an age na you store passwords and stuff on just a notepad or like an Excel sheet, and you should have it protected.
Yeah.
So mabuti na lang kasi ngayon. Okay, so ngayon before kasi nandun tayo sa part nung ano, career ko na between 2005 2008. Okay, alam mo yung mga internet cafes. Okay, so pero I think wala na ngayon yun. I mean, close na sila ngayon because of the pandemic. Okay, but ngayon kasi the reason that also we have a certain focus on information security kasi people are on work from home. Okay, and then itong pinakamadalas na napapansin ko, and it's actually okay, wala na to sa ano, hindi na siya technical topic. So, I think when you'd send your emails, okay, you have to be really focused on what you're doing. Kasi yung iba na napapadala sa, yung diba pareho ng pangalan, ng first name, iba yung surname, doon nila pinapadala. And that's critical for HR practitioners, especially those who are involved in payroll management.
Yeah. Yeah, yung I think na mention ko kanina, that's my first example ng confidentiality leak, 'di ba? Yung missent na emails. Yung pinakamahirap, no? Masend mo yung payroll file sa ibang tao, no? Even within your company, yun na nga, hindi malalaman na nilang lahat kung ano yung sweldo ng bawat isa.
So anyway, so we're wrapping up. So ito long, so just an awareness, okay? So the message for this episode is just an awareness on how we are protecting our information, personal information, yeah, company information. But anyhow, okay, I think that people are going to savor whatever you shared, John, okay? But moving forward, okay, how can people contact your company should they be needing help in, you know, character reference checking or cybersecurity?
Yeah, for any employment or background screening requirements, you can go through our website, yung vanguardscreen.com. No? So that's for Vanguard Screening Solutions. For any cybersecurity consulting requirements, they can go to Exeleus.com. Exeleus.com.
Okay. And then it's nice to have you again. And how about you, Ken? How can they catch your coaching, seminars, or webinars?
On my personal Facebook page and Cryptamad. Mm-hmm. And sa personal wall ko. Later, I think I'll be doing how to survive the bear market. A possible bear market. This is for some of my friends, me included, will be sharing yung mga experiences namin mula nung 2017 to 2018, 2019, the bear market ng crypto. We'll be sharing mamaya, mga 10 p.m. Ayun. Yun pa lang naman. And I think I'll be doing a sales workshop with Arriva this coming February. And I think this March, I'm planning to create a workshop about manipulation. Ayan lang.
Okay, great to hear. Yeah. And then for our viewers, okay, this evening, okay, thank you once again for patronizing and, watching our FB Live interview. And then if there is anything that we can help you with, I'm actually a message away on my Facebook Messenger, on the Facebook Messenger. And then for 2022, okay, we will be, trying to research and trying to be on the lookout for very relevant topics for our interviews. Okay, yeah. So we'll call it a day, and thank you, John, once again.
Thank you as well. If you need to discuss anything that you think I can help, just holler.
Yes. Yeah, so holler, call out John's name, or maybe go to FB Messenger as well. Yeah. So anyway, guys, okay, FB, HR Shouts community members, okay, please be safe. Okay, until next episode, I'll see you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye, Chris. Bye, Jen.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye. We'll be right back.